I do, in fact, need to hear more of Gracie Abrams' music. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel. My name is Beth, if you are new here, and I like to talk about music. A few months ago, I actually listened to Gracie Abrams for the first time, and I listened to her album, This Is What It Feels Like. Nothing could have prepared me for how obsessed with that album I became. I listened to it just like over and over again at nighttime in my apartment, and it is just such a stunning album. It is so beautiful. It's like a diary entry, but also the melodies and everything is so strong. And I do feel like not enough people are talking about it, and not enough people are talking about Gracie Abrams. So I do want to be one of the people that is talking about her, because I think she's insanely talented, and that is an insanely, insanely good album. So today I'm going back and listening to her first album, or first EP. It is called Minor. Without further ado, let's get into the first track. It is called Friend.
Pictures of the old days got me feeling older.
Okay. Wow.
You had no problem leaving. The best of this, you just want to leave. Oh, I'm killing me a little bit, and I hate the way you love me. How could you think I'd be your friend?
We're already getting the diary songwriting that I heard, and This Is What It Feels Like. I mean, literally every song she writes just feels like it came straight from her diary, but I can't describe it, but like she still manages to make it sound better than any diary entry ever could, if that makes sense. There are some songs that sound like diary entries and they end up just sounding very generic. And I wanna stress that that's not her. Like that is not what she's doing. It feels really interesting and personal and just like really vulnerable, and I'm also really loving the sound of this. I really love this. Okay. That is not what I was expecting.
I'm sure you're doing fine, but I don't want to hear it.
Yes.
If I left my t-shirt, you can keep it.
I just love this.
Don't want to see you again if it's different. I'll only see all the things that I'm missing.
Okay, I love stuff like that. I love it when an artist like doesn't finish the sentence and instead goes into the next one. I'm always immediately impressed that their mind came up with that. Also, like, do you hear the production? Do you hear the melodies? Oh, I love the sound of this. Like, really? What the heck, Gracie?
Now I'm the one to feel it.
That dirty little bass guitar.
Guess you got the best of this.
The echoes are a personal attack. Oh, I had chills a little bit during that as well. That was just on level with the This Is What It Feels Like album for me. Just catchy, but also very pretty. Feels like a diary entry. It feels universal, like anyone could kind of relate to that song, you know, or at least understand the story that she's telling. I don't know, I'm just like, wow. truly, truly, I cannot stress, she's so good. Immediately just so beautiful.
I missed your 21st birthday. I've been a bit on. Hate to picture you half drunk, happy. Thought you'd see it coming, but you never could. Sometimes I go blurry eyed. Small talk, and you tell me that you're on fire. Lights on.
Do you hear her melodies? What is this?
See the look in your eyes.
Oh my god.
Biting my tongue. You'll oh my god. Oh my life. I'm already under. I get a little bit along
I don't want to pause it because it's so good, but I have to say something or else it's just literally me sitting here. The layered vocals, the melodies, the structure of this, the bones of this song are so good. Like the melodies, the production, the structure, her vocals, the layered vocals. She builds the song in a beautiful way. Like it came in a little bit stripped back and then it's building. Like it's building. She's adding things throughout the song, which is always like my love language.
Sometimes I go blurry eyed. Small talk and you tell me that you're on fire. Like the night is over. Don't call me up, I'm already under.
Oh, the instrumental break is breaking me. Oh my, this is just everything, isn't it? It's now my mission to make sure more people talk about her music. I am wildly obsessed. I don't know why more people aren't talking about her. I really don't. Like, this is just so, so good. But, okay. Yeah, I love that. I love that so much. Again, her lyrics are just really beautiful. Like, they truly are so beautiful. And her melodies and the way that that built and the vocals, everything just took me out. Yeah. The next one's called Under Over. And I will say she mentioned something about under in the last song. So I do wonder if that's connected or if it's totally separate.
And I think about the months that I cannot get out of bed.
Oh, we're sad, Bob. She sounds like she has a lot of heartache, angst, and drama in her life for someone who is, what, 21, 20? Girl, like, are you okay?
I was barely sleeping, swimming in the memories, floating in the deep end. How come you're not still in my head? I got, you got, we got too much time on our hands.
Oh, whoa.
I'm not chasing feelings that I don't understand. I'm underwater, but I'm over you.
Oh, okay, that's interesting.
Thought that I'd be good the day I took down all your pictures. Used to be so caught up in the things we had planned.
I love the production.
Am I over you?
Oh, am I over you? Okay. Yeah, I like that one too. I didn't like it quite as much as the first two, but I did like it. I really love the production. It was a cute little beat. I heard the beat, don't you worry. Once again, like, she just kind of has a way with her words. She's just a very good songwriter. Like, I don't know what else to say. The next one I'm really interested by, it's called Teehee. Teehee. Is she gonna work that into the song? Or is it just gonna be, like, what? I have so many questions.
Drowned in bathtubs.
How much angst does she
have? I never said.
No, but really, can we talk about, like, how much angst? Is she okay? Like, is she good? Is she okay?
Should've called it, but we never gave it up. I know it wasn't right, wasn't right. We pretended to hold it when quiet.
Oh, I love that note.
Slept on floors of angry mornings, but you never let me in. Tearing every wall and breaking down the doors, kept bending every rule till all of me was yours. And pretended to hold.
Why is this called Teehee? We're not laughing, we're crying, if anything.
On the time that we broke it, when
I love that. That is so beautiful. Wow. Okay. Oh, like there were some really, really standout parts of that song. I didn't like that one as much as I liked the first couple of songs, but I still did like it. I loved the line where she said quiet. Like that was just absolutely stunning. But like that was so sad. Like why is it called Teehee? So I feel like that needs to be renamed to Boohoo or something. The next song is called I Miss You, I'm Sorry. great. Like, let's just be really sad tonight.
Do you remember happy together? I do. You sick to your stomach, is that still true?
That's
said forever. Oh. In the end, I fought it. Thought you'd hate me, but instead you called and said I miss you.
I have chills,
Good to each other, give it the summer. You said forever, and I almost bought it. I miss fighting in your old apartment.
I feel like I need to be at a concert with my light on.
Nothing happened in the way I wanted.
Oh my god. I feel like she has to have been inspired by Taylor Swift. Like, some of these lyrics, I do know that she, like, went to Taylor Swift's birthday party. So, if I didn't know that, you know, it's like, who knows? But I do think it's definitely, definitely possible that she was inspired by Taylor Swift to some degree. But obviously, still her own artist, you know, still her own person. But, like, I hear Taylor, like, I hear everything was haunted, nothing happened the way I wanted, everything was haunted, like, that just kind of sounds very Taylor Swift to me.
I'm talking, but I miss you, I'm sorry, I don't want to go, everything I know brings me back to
love. Oh my god.
Everywhere I go leads me back to you.
Oh, and I love a cutoff ending. I do have to say, like, she just ended the song, like, and that really hit. Oh my gosh, like, yeah, if that's not one of the best songs on the album, I don't know what is. Yeah, that was one of my favorites so far. That was absolutely stunning. I'm obsessed, obsessed, obsessed with the chorus. And then I lost my mind at the end when she converged the melodies. Anytime an artist does that, immediately I'm impressed, I'm healed. Every time an artist does that, I just, like, I can't. Every time an artist does that, I just, like, cannot handle it. Frickin', like, New Year's Day by Taylor Swift when she converges the melodies. So rude. Like, it's so rude, honestly, because they know what they're doing. Like, they know what they're doing when they do that. The next one is called Long Sleeves. And I do wonder, like, what's up with the capitals on this album? I guess every title is capitalized except for Teehee and Minor and 21. It's obviously a number, but I always wonder, like, why artists capitalize certain song titles and don't capitalize others. It could just be that that was how it was saved in their notes app on their phone or something in this day and age. Like, I'm sure it all goes back to technology.
You were the catalyst. I don't know what it is about how you breathe.
Ooh, so
about how you breathe.
This is so beautiful. Oh.
I want to be alone. Hated that you're good to everyone. All of them but me.
There's something about this that's just, like, magical.
If you hear me leaving, could you just pretend that it was only when I can't love you, even if I want to? It's been a long time coming. Never mind the thing, used to the turbulence, I wore long sleeves.
Oh my god, this is so beautiful.
Swept under surfaces, never enough of it. You didn't think it, cause I can't love you.
Beautiful thing. This is so pretty. I cannot. I gotta go.
I'm coming down.
Okay. The ending of that song was so masterful. Like, the way she stripped it back. Oh, like, it was like an onion. Like, she peeled away the layers of everything. And, oh, that was my favorite so far. I don't know what it was, but, like, I literally was tearing up a little bit at the line, like, if I leave in the morning, can you pretend it's the wind? Just everything about that, like, the delivery. She has this way of, like, really, like, breaking your heart with the way she sings things. And it just broke my heart. I really, really felt it. And that, like, I don't know what it was about that song, but it just felt so magical to me. There was like an aura around me or something. Sounds weird, but you know when a song just, you just put it on and you don't even like register what's happening fully? It just feels like it becomes the atmosphere. Does that make sense at all? That's how I felt with that song. It became the atmosphere. I wasn't like, oh, this is a song. This is a great song. I was like, I'm enveloped in this world. And yeah, I very much feel that way with all her songs. I really do feel like I'm enveloped in this world of her and I guess her life, her story, you know, her pain, her struggles. Whenever I step into her album, I'm like, let's do this. And then by the end, I'm like, wrecked. The last song is Minor. It's the title track. So interesting. Interested to hear what this one's all about.
Hit me 3-1 though, and I'll be home at some point past sundown. You already know that.
Oh my god!
I'm sorry, your house is in Glendale or somewhere far.
This is.
I would run for miles to get to you. M-I-N-O-R. I'm all out of luck.
Oh.
A minor league star.
Yeah. I will say I don't know how I felt about the whispering, to be real with you. I don't know. Like, sometimes whispering in songs takes me out of the moment almost. But, ooh, this is still really pretty though. I literally just whispered that.
Your house is in Glendale or somewhere far. I would drive all night to get to you. My car fuel is early.
I thought she said car fuel earlier in the song, but she said curfew. I always have a fun time seeing what lyrics I miss here in songs.
I would run for miles to get to you.
I love that so much.
M-I-N-O-R.
I love that.
And it's not your fault.
I love it.
Just how things are. I'm minorly stuck.
Whoa. Like, she's in the studio or something. Ooh, okay. That was beautiful. What the heck? Yeah, this was an absolutely gorgeous album or EP. I'm not sure which it is. But oh my gosh, like, this was just as good as This Is What It Feels Like. She's just, like, what? Like, she's so freaking good. There were a couple songs in the middle that I wasn't as crazy about as some of the other tracks. Friend, 21, I Miss You, I'm Sorry, Long Sleeves, Minor. I absolutely obsessed with all of those songs. Long Sleeves, ooh, Long Sleeves. Oh, her music is just really stunning. Her melodies are always really strong. And her lyrics really like bring you into that mood and that atmosphere. Like, it's very atmospheric music. Kind of like Conan Gray. Like, you really step into that world and it's just very like atmospheric and sad oftentimes. And this is like her debut. Like, what? This is her debut album. That's just crazy to me. Blown Away yet again by Gracie Abrams. And that was really sad, but really pretty. This is my album ranking. What are some of my favorites? Some of my least favorites? Always open to change and evolve over time. And feel free to disagree with me. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did make it to this point, shout out especially if you're here after my first reaction to Gracie, which was a while ago. Feel free to like and subscribe if that's something you're interested in doing. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.